Video 1.6, NFT Metadata. In this video, we will cover the following topics. NFT Metadata. How NFT metadata is stored. Decentralized storage of metadata. What is metadata? Metadata simply refers to data that describes other data. Therefore, NFT metadata refers to data that describes the NFT. This typically consists of the NFT's properties, such as the NFT's name and description, as well as the assets that the NFT is comprised of, such as the media, text, or code that the NFT represents. We can see why this is important. NFT metadata is the essence of the NFT itself. This is also why we would be interested in knowing about NFT metadata. As the owner of a potentially valuable NFT, you would want to know how it is formatted, and especially, how it is stored. Typically, NFT metadata is stored in the form of a JSON file. JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation, and is a lightweight file format, in the sense that it is easy for humans to write and machines to understand. This file contains the text-based data in the NFT and can link to external media. NFT metadata is stored on either of two ways, on-chain or off-chain. On-chain metadata refers to metadata that resides entirely on the blockchain. Off-chain metadata, on the other hand, refers to metadata that partially exists outside of the blockchain. This may seem confusing at first. Why would NFT creators choose to store their precious NFT metadata outside the security and immutability of the blockchain? The truth is, blockchains have limited viable storage space. The creation of each block entails multiple steps. For one, you have to compete with other users for the limited number of blocks being minted every minute. The gas fee you fork over each time a transaction takes place or an NFT is minted goes towards incentivizing miners to tend to your request first. Storing media such as images or videos occupies much more space than text, leading to much higher gas fees for transaction and creation. As a result, most NFTs that represent photos, videos, or 3D renders contain a link within their on-chain metadata that references the respective media file. This media file will be stored elsewhere on the internet, such as the artist's personal website, or a cloud hosting platform such as AWS. This poses a great problem to NFT owners. If the off-chain media that the NFT represents is lost, either due to corruption of data or the cessation of hosting of the media, the link in the NFT's on-chain metadata would become a dead link. It would not return any data, and the NFT would likely be rendered worthless. But fear not, although this may seem to be a major drawback to NFTs, there do exist solutions that make the external storage of media near immutable and permanent. Decentralized data storage is a solution. IPFS is a distributed system that allows for accessing data, files, and websites stored in a decentralized manner. IPFS stands for InterPlanetary File System. The word interplanetary refers to its decentralized nature. IPFS stores data using a peer-to-peer network. That is, data is stored across a network of computers in a decentralized manner. Each machine on the system is referred to as a node. Data stored using IPFS is copied and stored on multiple nodes. Therefore, nodes can use peer-to-peer verification to confirm any data's authenticity. This system also implies longevity. As long as there are a healthy number of nodes, data will persist through time. In turn, some IPFS systems incentivize nodes to host data, thus contributing to a healthy supply of nodes. IPFS also allows for Content-Addressable Storage, CAS. To understand this, let us use a standard web link as an example. As we can see, the link uses a top-down approach and denotes the particular path that the web page resides in. Let us compare this with an IPFS link. As we can see, it looks quite different. The link contains a content identifier, that's the alphanumeric string in the link. This content identifier references the content itself as opposed to the location of the content. This provides for an added layer of verification. You can be sure that the content is what you wanted by matching the content identifiers. It also ensures the permanency of IPFS links, since they are tied to the content itself rather than where it is stored. Standard web links may not work if the data has been moved to a different location. This brings us to the end of this video. In this video, we covered the following topics: NFT metadata, how NFT metadata is stored, decentralized storage of metadata. In the next video, we will learn about token standardization.